These are extraordinary times. Keep in mind that there is a war on. The war is a war for your attention. Okay. There is an incredible war taking place, a war for your attention. Woke up at 4 in the morning last night, couldn't sleep. I decided to try something, and I said, I'm going to put my mind on the light. I want to see the light, light, instead of light, not. It's hard to use words. I'm going to put my mind on the light that is light, instead of the light that is appearing to not be light. Even though it's still light, it's giving the impression of not being light. So the light that is not appearing to be not light, putting my attention on the light, okay? And I was able to do this to some extent. And then I was able to watch how my attention would plunge back down into not light. Light, not light. The light that appears to not be light. And all of the drama in this world. And then I'd catch it and I'd say, whoa, no, that's not the light. That's not the light. That's not what I really want. Let me get my attention back to the light. And I put it back, and then it would plunge down again. And it went on and on and on. Tremendous battle. And I realized that this is true meditation. This is what meditation actually is. It's your attention. Where are you putting your attention? It's like, wow. And it's very important to note that this electromagnetic realm is the light, not light realm. The light of apparent, where light appears to be distorted, where it appears to be not light. The appearance of light, not light. The light appearing to not be light. This is this electromagnetic realm. And all of this stuff is generating all this drama and thinking and thoughts and reactions. All of that is humming constantly. But like a dream. It's a dream. This consciousness here is like a dream. A dream world, a dream realm, this electromagnetic realm. And it's important to note also that Jesus coming here, the people want him to stay here and said, we want you to be Lord of this realm, King of this realm. We want you, your God, will worship you as God here. And Jesus said, no way. He said, this is not my realm. This is the realm of the King of darkness here, right? Prince of darkness, this realm. This is the realm where it appears as though light has been changed, distorted and changed, even though it hasn't been. So he said, no, I'm going back to my Father's kingdom. That's where I belong. So, and there's still to this day, this belief that Jesus is coming back to be Lord and King of this electromagnetic realm. There is no way that that's going to happen like that. Jesus coming back means helping us move our attention off of this realm. There's actually nothing we need to do about this dream except to shift our attention off of it. Shift our attention from this realm to the higher realm where the light appears more as the light. Okay, appears more as the light. As I said, the light has stepped down about 5 times. Even above this realm, it's about 5 times stepped down from the clear light. But certainly, this realm here is the worst, heaviest distortion of all. And like a dream, all we need to do is awaken from it. We do not need to change anything about the dream. So do not fight your thoughts. Realize this isn't you. This isn't me. This isn't what I want. This is not where I want my attention. This is not where I want my attention. This is simply a play that light is putting on because we requested this play. So we simply say, you know what, I'm not interested in this play. I'm going to turn my attention somewhere else. We don't have to know anything about this play at all. There's nothing we need to learn here. No lessons we need to learn whatsoever. We don't need to know the names of the actors in the play, what they're doing. We simply, just like in a dream, when you awaken for a dream, you say, wait a minute. Now, what were the names of all the people in the dreams and exactly what were they doing and how is this all going to work out? You realize that was just a silly dream I was having, a play that I was putting on in my mind. Same thing with this entire electromagnetic realm. Okay. We don't need to know anything about it. Just shift your attention off of it to the light. The light as light. A light appearing as light. Light reassuring us that light is light. The reassuring light. Okay. Electromagnetism is not the reassuring light. It's the frightening light. It's the light that seems to be frightening us. You know, because it seems to be in control, rather the other way around. Where light is the servant of spirit. It's wonderful, all-inclusive, all-supportive, all-reassuring, giving spirit whatever it desires. Whereas in this electromagnetic kingdom, it seems as though light is, you know, forcing everything to dance to its tune. So all we need to do is put our attention on the light. And then we say, oh yeah, now I see that this electromagnetic dance was just a play that light was putting on for me because I requested it. That's all I need to know about it. And you just realize, oh, I have no interest in that. What interest could we possibly have trying to learn that light isn't light? I mean, why watch a play like that? It's meaningless. It's absolutely meaningless. Because it simply isn't true. So, I mean, what application could it possibly have? None. It has zero application. This whole realm, electromagnetic realm, has zero application. So, there is this war for our attention taking place. And what the war is where do you place your attention? There's this fanatical side who insists that electromagnetic realm is the only realm there is. This is our home, and all of our attention needs to be placed on this realm. That is what their objective is. Okay, absolute folly. Okay, absolute folly. Sheer ignorance. Sheer unadulterated, unconscionable, arrogant ignorance. Okay, that's what's at play. And then there are others who say, whoa, no, I don't want to put my attention on this realm. When I came into this realm, I tried to keep my attention on higher realms. I wasn't able to because the world in here insists that this is reality. This is the only place there is. This is the light. This is the way the light is, the way we think it is. They say, well, this is a new light. This is a different light. This is the way light is. You know, all this stuff is not true. None of that's true. So we have this tremendous war for our attention. Okay, it's a war for our attention. Where do we place our attention is the war that is taking place in this world. Now just let that sink in for a while. And it's way more important war than guns and bombs and stuff. Way more important. Where you place your attention is all important. That's your freedom, isn't it? So you're being told you have no freedom. This electromagnetic realm is all there is. What an absolutely dastardly, you know, position that is, right? And in spite of the testimony of great helpers here, this continues on, unabashed. They're unabashed. They're shameless, absolutely shameless, to say you must put your attention on this realm. No. Put your attention on the reassuring light, the light that reassures us that this realm was all just a play of light, and the light has not been distorted, it has not been changed, it is the exact same one light. And since it was only a play to convince us that the light has been distorted and changed, which in fact it cannot be, it was all a mirage. It was all a silly mirage to try and convince us of something that can never be true. Therefore, it's not deserving of any attention, really. So what I found in meditation is it's your attention that's shifting. Like, I thought, like, I needed to struggle with the content when I got pulled away from the light, reassuring light, into all this drama light. I said, and the tendency is to want to struggle with the drama that you're starting to see, all this drama in the world. And then I realized, no, just say, I don't want this. This isn't the reassuring light. And I pulled my attention back to the reassuring light. That's how you do it. You do not react to what's going on in the world. You do not struggle with it. You just say, oh, this isn't the reassuring light. put my mom, I want my attention back on the reassuring light. So I see this is real meditation. I say, oh, okay, this is what the real meditators are actually doing. Okay, awesome. That's very great. It makes sense how they seem very passive towards this world, right? I mean, they're not struggling with this world. They're just shifting their attention to the reassuring light instead of the unassuring light. How do you say that? The dismal light, the light that appears to be dismally unreassuring, shifting it from to the reassuring light. Off of the discouraging light. The light as discouraging, we shift our attention to the light as reassuring, encouraging. The light here discourages us from believing that light is light, and the encouraging, reassuring light reassures us that light is light. So where do you want your attention? You can't have it on both. You'll be completely confused. So we're not asking anyone to be completely confused. We're saying one or the other, one or the other. And of course, those who are on the other side of this war insist that the best you can do is, well, do both. So what they're really telling you is you can either be totally discouraged and believe that light isn't light, or you can be completely confused by thinking it is, it isn't, it is, it isn't. And those are the only options you have. No, we have a third option, and that's to put our attention on the reassuring light. So it doesn't really matter what the realm of electromagnetism does. The play here doesn't matter at all. God is not watching this play. God is not following this play. Say, what's going on there? what's going on in the play of light pretending not to be light? As if some terrible outcome could happen. Like, you know, as if light could not be light. No, God created light. God knows light is light. God is not the slightest bit interested in any play that is for the purpose of light not being light. It's all an illusion. It's all self-deception. God's only interested in, hey, you got a severe continuity problem. Let's make sure that you get the maximum help for that so you can turn to the reassuring light. The reassuring light is not the clear light, okay? It is a special stepping down of the light, as it were, for the purposes of reassuring us that light is light, okay? Light is light. Call it the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is able to step light down from the clear light. In reality, light is absolutely clear. Just as spaciousness has absolutely zero dimensional, pure spaciousness is zero dimensional, light is totally clear. Now, we're not able to, it's too much of a continuity leap for us. So God created the Holy Spirit as a blessing, and the Holy Spirit's able to step down the light without getting trapped in it, in the stepping down process, without feeling that light has been distorted or changed, and is able to come down and to this electromagnetic realm and then have the step down light above the electromagnetic realm, and yet not too far above it, just a little bit above it. So it's not sharing at all in the distortion, appearance of distortion of electromagnetic realm. So we can then experience this light, and it's reassuring. It's called the reassuring light. It's like totally passive, totally still, totally calm. It's this wonderful, absolute calm and stillness. The light is just present. It is simply just present. And then we say, oh, wow. And this gives us a soft landing out of this, our attention, gives a soft landing to our attention out of this electromagnetic realm. We don't need to put our attention here at all. Because it's just a play of light, remember that. Just a play of light. Nothing's happening. So the whole thing is our attention. Where do we place our attention? And those who seem to be trapped in this realm, it's simply their attention that is engrossed in it. That's all. They too can turn their attention to this reassuring light that the Holy Spirit has brought to us. And the Holy Spirit says, just rest here in this light, abide in this light, live as this light. I have no needs, I have no needs. Now, this massive war that's taking place in the world is generating all this idea of needs. One of the best meditations or declarations, affirmations that say, I have no needs, I have no needs. Instead of saying, oh my gosh, I've got all these needs, how do I meet these needs? Say, no, I have no needs. I don't have any needs. And then the light has to conforms to that declaration, I have no needs. So, this will somehow smooth out functioning in this world as long as the body remains here. Even though your attention is on the reassuring light, your body still has an appearance here. But you say, I have no needs whatsoever, none. And so then you cannot, somehow the situation that adapts has to adapt to you being able to function however the Holy Spirit wants you to function here without the sense of, oh, I have some need that I have to work on, put my attention on neediness, right? So we declare our attention is not going to be going on neediness. It's going on to the reassuring light. I have no needs. I abide with the reassuring light. I live as the reassuring light. I have no needs. I have no needs. And the more that you make these declarations, the more comfortable you get with this. And so you just say, oh yeah, sure, I'm, of course I see the light. Of course I'm enlightened. Enlightenment means you see your attention is on the reassuring light. That's all. You just shift your attention to the reassuring light. And now you're enlightened. So I'm abiding with this light now. I'm abiding with this light. I'm abiding with this light experience. I'm abiding with this reassuring light experience. And I'm living as that light in the world. Means I have no needs. I have no needs. Don't play the game of electromagnetism, which insists you have all these needs and keeps manufacturing needs for you. Say, no, 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 I don't have any needs. I do not have any needs whatsoever. And then the world will give the appearance as though you don't, you're not lacking, right? That's the appearance that will show up in this world for others to see who still have their attention in this world is like, wow, you know, whatever you need, you seem to have it. You know, it's just, and yet it doesn't scare them thinking like, what's going on? It's just this seemingly just, you don't have neediness. It doesn't exist in your experience at all. That's what they say, those whose attention is fully on the reassuring light, they are able to function here in the world, and it whatever they need, it always shows up. They always have whatever is necessary for whatever they're doing, as if without any effort on their part whatsoever. That's because they insist, I have no needs. And you can also insist, I was never born. I was never born. Therefore I have no needs. If you don't have a need for the light to pretend to not be the light, then what needs do you have here? None. So then the light, you can have the light as your ally, supplying whatever is required to function here, instead of placing needs upon you like some evil dictator. So, I was never born. I was never born. No one's ever been born. We're watching a play of all this birth and death. The ones that are watching the play, they're not being born. It's just a play of light. A vibration. A waveform's vibration. particles, you know, all this coalescing and uncoalescing, arising and falling. It's just a play. We're not being born. We were never born. I've never been born. I've never been born. I am. I have no needs. I abide with the reassuring light. I live as the reassuring light. I have no needs. I've never been born. I have never been born. How could I have needs that I've never been born? Now it takes will and faith, intuition, and will to state this, because of course the electromagnetic realm is asserting just the opposite, of course. But remember, it's only asserting it because we told it to. We're the ones who are insisting upon this apparent assertion from light. But light's not making the assertion. We are. It's just giving form. It's giving appearance and realism to our assertion. Okay. But we can assert the opposite. Say, no, I have no needs. Then it will give a realistic. You know, it will conform to that. So we say, no, I was never born. I've never been born. I have never been born. All of this consciousness, life, you know, consciousness here in this world, existence consciousness, is something that's been imposed upon me, so to speak, like a play that I'm supposed to react to. But if you realize it's just a silly play of light pretending to not be light, why do I need to react to it? Why do I even need to have my attention on it at all? It's just playing with our attention. So I was never born. I was never born. I've never been born. And nothing's ever been born. No such thing as birth. No such thing as birth. No such thing as death. I've never been born. How can I die? Never been born. I have no needs. I've never been born. I have no needs. My attention is on the reassuring light. So you can see how this side of the situation here is so very different than those who are insisting that our attention be placed on this realm. You know, apples and oranges, it's utterly different. You can't mix the two. You mix the two, you get this just absolute mess. So of course, the other side will say, oh, sure, yeah, I'm willing to mix them. No, they're not, because that would be utter chaos, utter confusion. Nobody's willing for that. Nobody. So that's a lie. When they say they're willing to mix it, it's not true. Nobody can tolerate this utter confusion of trying to mix truth and lies. You have to drop it. So that's a false offer. But they have no choice but to go back to their position or choose this position of, you know, either one or the other. You can't do both. You cannot do both. So anyone asserts you can do both, you know they're on the side of attention onto electromagnetism, which is trying to deceive themselves. They're on the side of self-deception, for sure. For sure. Because those who are going to put their attention on the reassuring light know that you cannot do both simultaneously. You'll be utterly confused. So they're not going to ask you to do both. They're going to say, no, choose one or the other. It's the adversary. You'll say, oh, no, we can do both. We can compromise and do both. That's a lie. And we have to repudiate that and say, absolutely not. Attention fully on the reassuring light. Cannot do both, one or the other. Either you're born or you're not born. You can't have it both ways. Either you've been born or you've never been born. This realm claims you can have both light and not light. Okay, that's not true. Either light is light or it's not light. This is some other light. But if it is the light, then it's the one light. There's not two lights. There are not two lights. The idea you can have two lights is utterly delusional. It must be repudiated and most, you know, adamant terms, an adamant way. And this light, this one light, has no name, has no form, has no name. It is nameless, it is formless. There's no one that is that light uniquely whatsoever. This light is undefinable. It is that which gives us perfect freedom to all of reality, to choose whatever it wants to experience at any moment. But the light never loses its formlessness, in spite of the fact that it may be giving shape to, or giving essence to experiencing. It's actually essence that it actually gives. Clear light gives essence, not form or shape, but it gives the pure essence of any experiencing without losing its total spontaneity. Infinitely, endlessly, spontaneously free and present to present all essence, the essence of any desire that we have. The realm of electromagnetism tries to give a name to this light and a form to this light and claim this is reality. That's a big problem. It's called reification, concretization. Idolatry. What is everywhere? Why give a name to what is everywhere? Everywhere, pure spaciousness. Why does it need a name? what could that possibly, meaning could that possibly have? A name in distinction to what? Why is it your name is a reference referring to something defined? If it's totally free of all definition, why insist on putting a name on it? That's very much electromagnetic thinking, right? Thoughts, the thinking of electromagnetism. Remember, all this thinking is generated by this electromagnetism, by the light, in pretending to not be the light. It's not really our thinking. It's the thinking of this realm. It's the thinking of this play. It's the action of this play that is generating all these thinkings and reactions and thoughts and all. Those are not our thoughts. That is not our thinking. We are not thinkers or thoughts, reactors or so. No, we're the pure I am. So we can just say, I'm not interested in this play. Let me put my attention to the reassuring light. Just like on a television set, all the talk and the action we're watching, is that our thoughts and talk and action? Watching a television program? No. But we get into it as if it is. Like we're there when we're reacting, when we identify with an actor or actress and we think that they're speaking and that's us. Now disidentify from that, that's crazy. That's why I try not to watch any shows or movies whatsoever. I'll watch golf, just a little bit of golf, because they're not really trying to push some sort of scripted program upon you to capture your attention, right? Your attention can, you know, wander off here, wander off there. A lot of slow time somebody's walking along a fairway. Someone's looking at a putt, you know. So there's not much identification, you know, taking place. If you watch anything, make sure you watch something where it's really not capturing your identification very much at all, okay? Your attention is not easily not there. It's this dramatic stuff. It's the stuff that's intense, like consequential action is dramatic as far as this person and that person and this situation, and it pulls your attention in. That's what you have to be very, avoid that. All right, now as far as functioning care, well, we have no needs, but the light takes care of whatever functionality we need. We most certainly don't need to be statesmen, stateswomen, movers and shakers of this electromagnetic realm at all. Not at all. We're showing the way to be free from this diabolical situation, actually. Sargadatta said that somehow whatever he needs is there, and however he needs to function, it takes care of itself without him even having to think about it at all. just like automatically says, like hair growing. Hair just grows whether you think about it or not. And that's how he explains it. So that so we say, take our attention, put our attention just on the reassuring light. Our attention doesn't have to be on this, the world and the events of the world, what's happening here. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Jesus said it best, perhaps, is let the dead bury the dead. Let the dead bury the dead. Okay? He refers to those who are in, have their attention on this play of electromagnetism as the dead. They're dead. Their focus is, attention is on death, actually. The death of light. This world seems to depict the death of light and the resurrection of a new light. You know, the death of light. So he says, let the dead bury the dead. In other words, let those who want to have their attention on this play, let them take care of whatever they think they need to take care of here. It doesn't matter who is in charge, who are the big movers and shakers. I mean, it is totally irrelevant. Totally irrelevant. Our goal is to get our attention off of this play. Not to pick and choose favorites in the play. Get our attention off of the play. Onto the reassuring light. The light of reassurance. The vision of oneness. Get our attention on the vision of oneness. And that's all we need to do. That's it. And whatever functioning the Holy Spirit has for us to help reassure others, that will just like automatically take place without our need for any attention on it. That's the testimony of those who have done this. That's the testimony. It's like growing fingernails or growing hair. It just takes place without you having to put your attention on it at all. And of course, those who have their attention on this world say it's impossible because they don't. They think the light. This is a different light. See, it doesn't work that way. No, because we're saying the light is light. This is all play of light. We're choosing to be reassured by the reassuring light, the light of reassurance. That light is light. And that light will function to enable us to do this. Simple. What they're saying is, well, the way that this light is functioning in this realm, you can't do, you know, that light can't do it. Well, because we're telling it not to. But if we tell light to enable us to function this way, then we will be able to. Very simple. In the whole quote-unquote mind of electromagnetism, it's not our mind. We don't have to identify with that. It's a false self, a false mind that we're being presented with. And again, it's just simply a play of light. Don't confuse the play of light for a mind or for thinking. For, you know, no, it's not. So we don't have to identify with it at all. We don't have to put our attention on it at all. So we need to hear all this, hear it, keep hearing it. I spent my whole life hearing this, listening to those who advocate this, and just, so I'm just amplifying it and making sure that people keep listening, they keep hearing it. It makes a difference if you just keep listening, keep reinforcing. Gradually you start to come around to this recognition. You don't need to accept this compromise between light that appears not to be light and light that appears to be light. That's just utter confusion. So what they're really telling you is you have an option of utter confusion. Let's be honest, okay? They say you can either put your attention on the light that appears not to be light, or you can choose utter confusion. Those are your choices. And we say, no, your choices are, you can either put your attention on the light that seems not to be light or the light that appears to be light. That's your choice. That's your choice. That's everyone's choice. Now this war is about to shift phases big time into a way more aggressive campaign, as if it weren't aggressive enough already. But, you know, war is a nasty, nasty thing. And when you get an advantage, then you tend to then push the advantage, right? That's how the war works. When you gain a stronghold, foothold, then you say, okay, let's now really put on an all-out blitz and crush the opposition. So false flags are very useful in those sort of to give rise to this sort of, like 9/11 gave rise to an enormous push towards focusing our attention on this world, this realm. And there are likely to be other situations, but there's going to be a big, big push. So we have to be wise. Understand our position and be wise. Understand our position and be wise. There's the choices between attention on the light that appears not to be light or the light that appears to be light. That is the choice. Okay. We're not going to allow those who have their attention on the light that appears not to be light to dictate what our choices is, because they'll insist it's either that or total confusion. And total confusion isn't a choice. So we say, no, that is there's no choice at all you're presenting. So we're the ones who say what the choice is, because we're speaking truth. Not in insanity, silliness. It's one or the other. Put your attention on one or the other. Your goal is one or the other. Your goal is one or the other. So we know our goal. We have to be wise now. And we need incarnation of wisdom. We need an incarnation of this light almost, you know, of this utter passivity. This light appearing as light is this completely, you know, passive, still, calm light. So different than electromagnetism, right? There's no source of this light. It's light itself. It's not light shining from some sun, from star. It is self-effulgent light, but softly effulgent. Effortlessly effulgent, everywhere equally effulgent, totally passive. Not pushing any agenda whatsoever, no reaction whatsoever, utterly still, serene, tranquil, passive, light. And we simply put our attention onto this light. And this heals us and cools us down from this, you know, riotous madhouse of electromagnetic realm. And soothes our continuity fears. Now, those who want their attention to be on the electromagnetic sphere pay no attention to any such teachers or any such light, and completely ignore it, which is like, if you have an incarnation of this light in the world, which we have had, they ignore it. They pretend it doesn't exist. But we can't afford to ignore it and pretend it doesn't exist. That's a disaster. We tend to think, well, if they're ignoring it, maybe it's not important. No. They're ignoring it because they realize it undermines their position, so to speak. It weakens their resolve, for sure. So they will act as if, I mean, you look at the great incarnations and the modern world and how much attention they avoid it like the plague. They avoid it like the plague. All this modern high-tech mindsets. They do their utmost to act, pretend it doesn't exist, never existed. Of course, because they want all their attention on this electromagnetic realm. believing that this is the new home, this is the new thing, and this is their creation, as it were. And they don't want anything that attracts them towards the light that appears as light, towards the light that appears not to be light. And they don't want to be attracted away from that. So of course they're going to ignore it. They're going to ignore it. But that doesn't mean that we should ignore it. Nor should we lose heart because most of the world pays no attention. Because again, the overwhelming majority of the world will pay no attention. They're still trapped. Their attention still feels trapped in electromagnetism, this play. But they really don't like this play. And so they will be helped in some way to at least say, if they just, a little bit of help goes a long way here. So again, I asked for this day to be the day where we, this light that appears as light, as a remedy of the continuity problem, as the reassuring light, this reassuring, utterly passive light, let that light, let us be aware of that light. Let our attention be upon this light and give us the absolute reassurance and support of all types, always to help us put our attention on that light. This is the prayer that we must make in this situation now. Okay. All right. That's it for this video. Very great.